Enough, Goku! How far do you plan on going? This will do. Let's fight here. You have lost your right to choose.
Damn.
I've continued my research ever since you destroyed our Red Ribbon Army. Dedicating my life's work to defeating you.
So you've got a grudge against me?
Precisely. Through your fight with Vegeta, we were able to fully comprehend your power and techniques.
Well then, you forgot to study the most important thing, your loss.
You powered up quite impressively. But Android 19 should still be able to beat you.
Oh yeah? Well then, how about giving us a taste of this android's power?
Super Saiyans are incredible! He's on a completely different level than the rest of us!
I warn you, Goku seems on a whole fire. He seems like he's nearly at full power already. And yet, something seems off about him.
He's getting pummeled, but acting like it's nothing at all!
He's an android. I'll bet they don't feel pain or fatigue.
But...
I don't have time to play around. Come on!
Wait, I know. It's Dad's sickness.
You mean the disease that the kid from the future told us about?
It hurts. What's happening to my body?
I'm the one who's supposed to defeat Kakarot. I won't let some mechanical doll do it for me. I can already tell from watching you. You're not nearly as tough as everyone thinks.
I have already analyzed all of your combat techniques, Vegeta.
We're Saiyans. You'll need more than numbers to understand our power. Tell me, I'd like to know. Do androids feel fear?
Okay, grand as it can.
Vegeta went Super Saiyan? I thought you couldn't do that unless you had a completely calm heart.
My heart was calm. Calm and pure. Pure evil, that is. To become as powerful as I possibly could, I subjected myself to the most rigorous training. Eventually, I discovered a limit. I couldn't get stronger. And with my anger at its peak, it happened. I became a Super Saiyan. I was overcome with joy. I beat Kakarot and was ready to return as the Saiyan Prince.
That's enough nonsense.
Okay.
That's about what I thought you were doing. But I'm Super Saiyan. I get a bit more violent.
Escape!
Are you feeling fear yet?
is certainly outside of my calculations. But the fact still remains, your probability of victory is very low.
Trunks arrived late and became perplexed when he saw that the androids they were fighting were ones that he had never seen. Dr. Joro, sensing his great miscalculation, became determined to return to his laboratory. He took their own and then escaped from the threat. Dr. Joro was surprised as he leaved. Dr. Billow mentioned the existence of the 17 and the 18. Piccolo returned shutdown device. He is attacked from behind and then crushed. Trunks summoned the 17 and number 18 trying to activate number 16. Will be another actor during the day. He holds up his eye by the phone. He uses it. And then number 16 wakes up. But the injuries begin flying to a quickly start as they handle their fire. The hero will fire their engineers in a big chase to the front. Trunks tries to restrain them and he is done with the house back again.
Fine, I'll fight you.
Just so you know, I won't be holding back because you're a woman. Then again, you're an android, so you're not really a woman anyway.
You gotta be kidding! I have hoped for better.
You can't escape!
Tell them to take me down! damage or not. I guess I'll just have to prove you the extent of your warranty.
I had hoped for better. Hang on here!
Father, we have to go!
Get out of my way!
If you want to run, I don't blame you. We have no interest in those who run away.
You must be joking. Why would I run away?
I assume you consider your Saiyan pride important, so I'll warn you. If anyone interferes in this one-on-one battle, then I'll join the fight as well.
You'll keep fighting?
Of course.
That's more like it.
Darn it! Dad!
Take this!
I thought I warned you. If anyone interferes in a one-on-one battle, then I have no choice but to fight as well.
Come on, no way. He's got destroyed. He's got destroyed. Oh, back to you. Oh, it's a Tito? What?
I better make sure this pesky Saiyan can't use his other hand.
Oh no!
Don't worry. Everyone's still alive. Tell them I'd be happy for a rematch anytime. If they trained hard enough to be worthy opponents, that is. See ya.
Thank you.
Krillin asked the androids what their goal was as they began to fly away. Number 17 responded that it was only a game. With her bruised ego, Vegeta flew off alone, swearing vengeance. Piccolo headed for the temple, and after the last result, Plan 2 recognized what he was counting. Krillin and the others joined up with Gohan and hold a plan to Kami's house in order to hide Goku. Along the way, they contact Gohan, who surprisingly informed them of an abandoned planet that looks exactly like him. Elgo will aid his friends, undeniably at the same time as he left his life. Gohan and the others flew to the charge. Hypothesized that whoever came in the ship was responsible for changes to the timeline. Gohan then discovers a strange and recently showed skin of some creature. Trunks and the others are bewildered by nothing. That was the moment. Kami looks down on the screen from the temple and gets into the presence of the world. Kami brings the same ship to the future. He's no longer Kami, and no longer Piccolo. Sweet their man seems to be the only one to find the young leader.
So there you are.
Pardon?
Yes, and you'll be my next meal, King Piccolo.
How do you know my name? Who the hell are you?
I'm your brother.
What?
You're going to tell me exactly who you are right now.
Why should I? You'll be a meal for me soon enough, anyway.
Gonna fight?
Huh. Then I guess I'll just have to kill you. It seems you know the name Piccolo somehow. Unfortunately, you have me mistaken with someone else.
No sound.
You're saying that you're not King Piccolo?
That's right. The fact that you've absorbed the people in that town only works to my advantage.
Why do you say that?
Because it means I don't have to hold back! Stop you!
You think this will end well?
Huh? that all you got? Because I was sure you were a much more terrifying monster than this.
You're pretty impressive. Of course, I'm not in my perfect form yet.
Perfect form? So you came here in a time machine. Who sent you?
I did. However, I must say, I'm surprised that you knew about the time machine. That said, I doubt you know this. Kame!
Let me get much closer to my perfect form. You should feel honored.
Who the hell are you?
You're going to die, but I'll tell you anyway. My name is Cell. I'm an android.
We'll be right back. Where is he hiding? Do you have any idea, 16?
The radar shows nothing, but he must be either at the Capsule Corporation or Master Roshi's island.
And which is closer?
Master Roshi's house.
Let's go.
Where am I supposed to find it?
Perhaps you can tell me where to find Goku?
You really think I'd just tell you?
If you don't, I have ways of making you talk.
I think you'll find that's not so easy.
I find it hard to understand why you're so desperate to fight a battle you can't win.
That's not Piccolo. What's wrong?
Extraordinary power for a non-android. I agree that you don't appear to be King Piccolo. And I couldn't care less who you really are. I just want you to tell me where I can find Goku.
And I'm not gonna tell you!
Then I suppose we must fight once more, huh? But this time I'm afraid I won't be holding back. Oops!
What's wrong?
I can't!
It's over!
We're even with each other in terms of power, but his stamina won't be able to last much longer. My energy flows forever. I will never fade.
Uh-oh.
No!
Finally, the day I've longed for has arrived. The day when I will finally fuse with Android 17 and 18.
I don't know who you are, but you're in the way. Get lost. I'm playing with this guy right now.
17! This monster is planning to kill you and absorb your power! Run!
Got you! Rejoice, my brothers. For when you become a part of me, an unbeatable, super-powerful being will be born!
I've had enough of your babbling. Do you actually think we'll let you absorb us?
I don't care what you're going to let me do. I'm going to absorb you whether you like it or not.
Run, 17! We can't let him achieve his perfect form!
What's that? You want me to run away just when things are starting to get interesting? Don't make me laugh!
I'll finish you off!
Take this! What's wrong? Come on! Take this!
Looks like Piccolo going easy on him?
No. It's just... Cell is far too strong. Run 18.
Stop him!
You think this will end well?
Impossible!
I guess I'm just too powerful for you. Goodbye.
Time has come for me to fight before you. I like you guys. It was fun traveling with you.
Take this. Oops. Take this.
Oops.
You finished your pointless struggle. I think it's about time I stop you.
Too slow. Take this.
What's going on? So you want to throw your life away too?
16. Are you planning on sacrificing yourself?
By my calculations, Cell and I have almost the same level of power. It seems the only way for me to stop you from reaching your perfect form is to end your life.
You actually think that's possible?
I won't know until I try.
Oh, I know quite well.
I never knew you were this strong. 16.
17. Run away while you still can.
I would just run away? Get away! Bring it on!
Take this!
As you wish! Forgive me, Chacho. I feel like the end is near.
It's over.
No need to worry.
Check out my ultimate technique!
Okay, come on now.
patience.
What are you doing? Hurry up and get out of here!
That was some nerve for you to get in my way. I'm sure you die anyway, but let me speed up the process. Goku!
So you're Cell! I'll fight you in one day, and I'm going to defeat you! No question about that!
Save Tien, Goku used instant transmission on Kami's lookout to teleport and stand before Cell. Goku felt the pain power and sickness. He was still alive. He picked up quickly out of Tien and bowed Cell about the instant transmission. Cell decided that fighting another ET was one of his priorities.
Goku gives sentient beings to Trunks, who follows after Vegeta.
It is now time for Goku and Gohan to enter the hyperbolic time chamber. Meanwhile, Cell tries to go out from the 18th century hiding place of the Desert Island by blowing up the island of Earth. This is on the Royal Islands 1 after that.
Looks like they're really moving now.
Oh, okay.